What's going on, everybody? All right, I broke my Jeep. Sort of. It's like I can't fix it, but I did break it a little bit, and I broke it by washing it. And you might say, how did you break it by washing it? That's crazy gear. It's crazy, and it is. But what happened was, I have these aftermarket Rugged Ridge hood latches, and I think they're really beastly, but they have one flaw. And that flaw is, there is a plastic piece right here at the top, and I'll show you a closer picture of this here in a minute, that comes over, and when you latch this down, it actually hooks on this, and it's a safety latch is what it is. It's a safety latch. And I guess over time, just the heat from the hood, from the engine bay, the heat from the sun, hot and cold from over the years, just made that plastic brittle. And when I pulled this off to wash underneath it, the sponge caught it and snapped it right off. Man, I didn't even know I did it the first time. And the second one, I heard snap and heard it clang down and got to looking to see what it was. And that's what it was. Now, one thing about these are, you can see that these have silver threads, silver bolts, stuff like that. And I didn't like that, but I really do like the latches. The latches are awesome. And now that I know that piece can get brittle, I can be more careful when I wash underneath it. So what I found was these. And I actually ordered these off Amazon. You can get them, you know, Extreme Terrain, places like that sell this stuff. But it's the same identical one. It's the Rugged Ridge Aluminum HXD hood latches, but it has all black hardware. There's no stainless anywhere. I mean, I'm sure this is stainless coated, but it's not raw stainless. So, you know, there's not a lot of chrome or stainless stuff on this Jeep. So I kind of wanted to get rid of that. So, problem solved. The problem was, I wasn't willing to pay. I think these things are like $108. I wasn't willing to pay $108 just to swap out some stainless. But when I broke them, that gave me a good excuse to buy the ones that are blacked out. Now, I want to say I did contact Rugged Ridge, or I attempted to contact Rugged Ridge, and I left them a message, and I've not heard back from them, and that's been several hours ago, to see if I could just buy that piece. Because if I can, maybe I just give them away on the channel after I replace them with these blacked out ones. You know, they're still good, it just needs that piece. And if you don't care, it has the stainless on it, which I think one of them has a little bit of rust on as well, but it still works. So instead of paying $108 for a set of these, you can get a used set possibly for free later on if I can replace that piece. If I can't replace that piece, I'm just gonna throw them away because it's not safe to drive that way. But let me take you off the tripod. I'll show you what I'm talking about. Okay, so here's the latch that I currently have on. These are the ones that came on the Jeep whenever I bought it. You can see it's got some stainless right here, and it's got some stainless right here. And I think it's the other side stainless the same way. But when you unlatch these, and then of course this rod is stainless and there's some stainless bolts. This is what you see, and you can see right here that this is broken. And here is what this should look like. It should have this plastic piece here. You can see it just slides down on the back. So I would assume that I can probably replace this piece, or they'll send me this piece, and then I'll give these away if that's right. But you can see how it's supposed to work. And that right there, whenever you put these back up, latches over right in here and creates a safety latch so they don't just pop off or anything like that. So what we're gonna be doing today is actually removing these old ones and replacing them with the blacked out version. You can see this has blacked out hardware. The hardware on this will be blacked out on the new ones. So I'm gonna get these removed, or I'll show you how to remove these, and then we'll put the new ones on. Okay, so here's the tools you'll need to do this. You'll need a 13 and some kind of swivel extensions. You see these things do swivel a little bit, both these swivel. I got those at Harbor Freight. Luckily I had them from a long time ago. Trying to install a spark plug on Nextera, I bought those, and good thing, because I need them. You also need a 13 millimeter socket. You will need a 10 millimeter socket, a 16 millimeter open end wrench, a 4 millimeter Allen key, 5 millimeter Allen key, another 5 millimeter Allen key. I didn't have another one of those, so I stuck it in a screwdriver, which actually works out way better because this is a ratcheting screwdriver. So if you have one of those, you're gonna be better off. And a magnet. You don't really need a magnet, but it just made my life easier. When I'm taking out these right here, they actually go all the way through. And the one right here, since my Jeep is kind of sloped down the driveway, I actually pull the magnet back out. I do want to say, the bolt for this is back in there. And Jeep made that about as difficult as they possibly could to get to. That is why you will need one of these. And also on the new ones, the old ones actually have washers made into these. But the new ones, I've already got one side put on, have lock washers, or lock nuts, I guess I should say, and separate washers. And so does this one. So whenever you put this on, you actually have to hold a washer on back in there and start a lock nut. It's not exactly fun, but I'm going to show you how I did it. Okay, so the very first thing you need to do is actually unscrew the latch on the old ones. Now, if you don't have these, you'll just need to remove your factory latches. But since I had these on here, I actually had to remove them. And it's the same way of putting these back on as it is removing it, because it's the exact same latch. I just ordered mine with a black coating. Now you can see I pulled this side out, this side came out, this side is not, and that is why I said you need a magnet so you can pull that one out, and then your latch, it just comes off. Next, I gotta figure out how to get back into this. I could just snake it through the other side like so, and luckily for me, this side is the exact same way. And you can see how I've got this kind of snaked underneath this brace right here. Without the ratcheting, or no, without the universal extensions on that, it's almost impossible to actually get back in there. But there you go, I got it off. Now I just need to find that nut, because if I'm going to give these things away, I'd like to send all the hardware with them as well. I don't want to make people hunt for hardware. So I'm actually going to hunt for this nut. It may have actually fell out on the ground or something. I don't know. When I find that, I'll be back in just a second. Okay, yet again, I did find the nut. It is way down in here. And yet again, a magnet comes in handy. So I did find that. And I'm just going to put these back together like they came. And that way, if I can get the parts and give them away, they'll be assembled for the next person. Now, like I said, if I can get those parts to give these away, I'll be giving these away at some point in time. I will actually just stick them in the box that the other ones came in, and I'll give them away in the box and send the instructions along with them. You can watch this video, but I will send instructions with them. Okay, now comes the fun part. We do have to install the new latch right here, which is kind of a pain because you have to hold this washer on along starting this lock nut, like I said earlier, whereas the old ones didn't have that. But the old ones also didn't have a lock nut, so I would prefer to have a lock nut over not having a lock nut, so we'll put the washer on. I don't think these things would come apart anyway. I never had a problem with them at all, but if I can be a little bit more secure with a lock nut, I'm going to. Now these do have little tabs right here. Once you take this off, you'll see there's two little holes right here that these tabs line up with to help locate the bracket, so you can't put it on upside down. Okay, now comes the fun part of trying to get this lock, or this washer on there, which the washer, putting the washer on there isn't the hard part. The hard part is holding this nut, and the way I do this, I get it comfortably in my fingers like that. I stick it in here and line it up with the screw, and then I screw the screw into the threads. And it's just that easy. I made that look way easier than it actually is. And then just put your socket on it with your 14 swivels, your 5mm hex, tighten it down. All right, we have that on. That's the hardest part. I will tell you, that is the hardest part. And once you got it on, you can move this just a little bit to try to get it straightened up. And I will kind of straighten that up a little better once I get it all put on. Next,
reassemble your latch. Latches back on there. The next part is actually pretty easy. It's up here. All you really have to do is take these two nuts off, remove this piece, put the other two back on. That takes a 10 millimeter. And this part is easy peasy. You also need the 4 millimeter as a backup right here. Always good to have your ratchet in reverse. Where I was looking at it upside down, I flipped it back by accident. Like I said, this part is the easy part. There's no way to anything hard to get to on this. Here's the actual piece that broke off of this, is the whole reason I'm replacing them, which I do like the black, that one's better. But then again, like I said, if I can get those pieces, I'll give these away at some point in time. Let me go get the piece that goes up here. I'll be right back. I do want to show you, there's one last thing I forgot. They do send these little rubber stoppers with them. You just need to pop that little rubber stopper on right there. I did forget to do that. Don't forget to do that. It kind of latches on a little bit. But they do come with them, and you just need to put them on top of that. Okay, so when you're putting this on, this piece right here that broke goes towards the tops, and the hooks go towards the bottom. Of course, because you have to hook your latch into it. So that's the orientation. You will need a couple washers. It just slide in like so. Washer nut, and washer nut, and then we just need to tighten these down. It's almost over. It's really not that bad. It's just getting into that one right there that's the hardest part of it. There we go. This one you can get a little crooked. You can straighten it back up, but it don't have locators on it, so it will actually get crooked on you. So as you get it snugged up, just kind of make sure it's straight, line it up with the bottom a little bit. Make sure your rubber gasket is lined up pretty good. Now my last one, it did squish out a little bit, which is fine with me. I don't care if it squishes out. You know, you don't want to Hercules it, but snug them up. There we go. Make sure the top one didn't loosen, but it's tight in the bottom one. Pretty good right there. All right, the next thing is you put your hood down. Like so, and then you try your latch, which is a little bit crooked. And of course it doesn't fit. Let me move you over here and I'll show you how to adjust this. Okay, so as you can see, when I push down on this, this doesn't even come close. So what you need to do is actually loosen this top jam nut right there. And then you'll just unloosen this a few turns. Then try it again. It's still nowhere near it. So unloosen it a few more. It actually took quite a few on the other side, and it actually just popped out here. So I guess we need to loosen the bottom one as well. The other side, I may need to check, because I thought I actually had it pretty good. this one isn't lining up as well, so we're going to have to loosen the bottom one as well. We'll tighten the top one back up and actually screw it out of the bottom. A few turns. Yeah, this one's even tighter. It's like this one's actually jamming up right here. And I actually readjusted everything. But it's not, you can see it's actually sticking right there as well. So, if these are spread out too far, but you can definitely see wear marks right there. It's like these are spread out this way too much. I'm gonna look at the threads I have on the other side. I believe these are actually made wrong. If you can see, let me take you off the tripod. You can see how much thread I pushed out on this and how it's wearing there and wearing right there. Now let me take you over to the other side of the Jeep, and this one worked perfect. And it looks like there's about the same amount of threads, but there is very, very little wear on this side. You can see it just pops right on. And if I push down on the hood, it just pops right off. The only reason it didn't pop off is because the hood pulls up and it stays latched. But you can see that it doesn't catch at all. There's nothing binding that one up like the other side is. Okay, so you get the gist how to adjust it. You loose these nuts and unscrew this till it gets on. But I think mine actually has an issue. I don't know what that issue is just yet. I don't know if these are pushed out too far, but that's actually how you set these. I need to work with mine a little bit and figure out what exactly is wrong with it. Maybe take like a plastic hammer or something like that and peck on this or something. I'm not sure how I'm gonna fix that, but it is definitely wearing on the sides, just what little bit that I've done it. But that's how you adjust them. You loosen that jam nut, unscrew it till you get up there. When it pulls the hood down and latches it, you know you've got it done. But I actually must have a problem with mine somewhere. Okay, update. I did wind up getting this adjusted. You can see it's still rubbing. I don't know if that's exactly right, but it is adjusted. It does go on. I think it's just wearing off some of the coating. But you can see whenever it pushes down that the hood actually pulls down here. So we're good to go. I tried to actually lower it a little bit more and I couldn't get it to go any lower. So this must be exactly where it wants to sit. But you can hear it latches down. Everything seems to be working all right. But I had to work with this about another 5 or 10 minutes to get it. I guess, like I said, I think that you can see right here how much is actually wore down on the coating. I think that's actually what happened. The coating wore off more than anything else from just working with it. But if you have that problem, you can just keep working with it. Get the coating wore down and you'll see that it'll actually
work. I appreciate y'all watching this video. Please like, share, and subscribe. We'll see you next time.